today, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. I now give you the Sola Gratia Chorale.
To begin our musical worship this afternoon, let's all rise and sing Leaning on the Everlasting Arms.
Give our debtors, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory,
Psalm 145 verse 3 says, "Great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. His greatness no one can fathom." David learned that the way to life, or to live a life victoriously, is to remember the unsearchable greatness of our praiseworthy God. May the words of this psalm be a constant reminder that no matter what injustices and problems we may face in this fallen, sinful world, we have a God who is worthy to be praised for everything he has done for us in this age and in the ages to come.
Matiwa,
This has been beautiful so far. What do you guys think?
Yes.
I'm going to invite the director up for a moment. We're going to do a little bit of Q&A. We're going to get to know the choir a bit. So, Mr. Sai, tell me a bit. How did this choir start?
So, back in the Philippines, I was a high school teacher. I was teaching from 2017 until COVID happened. So, this students back here, they used to be my students. Some of them has been singing for 7 years in the group. And those are the oldest members. Who among you are with the group for 7 years now? Obviously, you will also notice that. and some of them younger. So COVID happened, and I got a scholarship at Andrews. And so we didn't see each other for quite a while, probably 2-3 years. So it's actually a happy reunion to see them again here. It's their first time to be in the US, so it's all because of God's grace that we are all here.
Awesome, awesome. So you guys sound amazing, just to put it out there. How did you deal with practicing during the pandemic and while you were studying here and you were separate? How did that work out?
I think Robbie would want to answer this for me. Just kidding. Robbie's my friend from Andrews University, but he knows. So they would come together every weekend in a rehearsal room, and I would join them through Zoom. So I would listen to them, and I would tell them what to do. And, well, we survived for the past 2-3 years. But I just want to acknowledge my assistant, Erickson. Wave your hand. He's been taking care of the group that I was doing.
Wonderful, wonderful. So now, correct me if I'm wrong, but they're all currently college students?
So, probably a number of them just graduated this year. And these are the first batch. And the rest of them, they're all college students. Oh, we actually have one high school student.
Wow.
Where's Kristen? She's actually the tallest, too.
Awesome.
she's grade 12.
Cool.
So, yeah.
Now, real quick, I just want to go down the line. What are you guys studying? Have you studied?
I studied BS Mathematics.
I'm an incoming fourth-year nursing student. I took up nursing.
Medical lab science.
Also medical laboratory science.
BS accountancy.
Nursing.
Great jobs in your high school.
I also study medical laboratory science.
BS aircraft maintenance technology.
BS electronics engineering.
AB theology, third year.
Physical therapy.
Nursing.
BS accounting information systems.
Nursing.
Business administration.
Wow, so wait, correct me if I... Yeah, yeah.
Also nursing.
I feel bad because I'm usually the pianist and I'm the one who gets forgotten, and I just forgot the pianist, so... Yes, we love you too. Question. So I was listening, and let me get this straight. Are any of you studying music? Wow! Look at that! Look at that! None of them are studying.
I do.
Well, of course, you know. No, he doesn't study music. He just directs, you know. But no, that's incredible. You guys sing so well, and you don't study music. That means you put a lot of time in and a lot of effort, and it really does sound good. So thank you guys for coming, and thank you for all you've shared with us so far, and we can't wait to hear what you guys have next for us.
For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. Surely he took up our pain and bore our suffering, yet we considered him punished by God, stricken by him and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to our own way. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Christ gave his life to give you yours.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us, have mercy. Lamb of God, you take away the sins. He ascended into heaven.
Despite just one life to live, the choices to make and paths ahead seem endless, and we are often confused as to which way we are to turn. While God has given us the freedom to make our own choices, sin constantly leads us the wrong way, and when we are faced with sin's dead ends, we find ourselves on our knees begging to God to get us out of where we are. Aren't you tired of getting lost, tired of all the wrong decisions you've made and the wrong paths you've taken? Instead of falling on your knees at a dead end, why don't you get on your knees before making your choices, before taking a road? Why not ask Jesus to take your hands and tell him, Lord, hold me. Let us sing, Nearer, Still Nearer.
Only my sin fall, now
Should find immense comfort in the fact that our God is an impenetrable refuge, that he will bring glory to his name among the nations and all the earth, and that he will protect his people and bring them everlasting peace. His word reminds us of who he is and calls us to worship in awe. Be still and remember who God is. Be still and see what God is doing. Be still and acknowledge his greatness. Be still and know that he is God.
Oh.
Time and time again, we are faced with decisions whether to choose Jesus, whether to choose life or death, fear and love, and ultimately, whether to choose Jesus or the illusory things of life. But what is our motivation for choosing Jesus? Is it only for the benefits, the reward of heaven, or our fear of hell? Or is it for our fellowship with Him, the delight of knowing Him more and sharing in His suffering? Would it be enough to have Jesus in your life? If so, let us choose Him who first chose us. Let us choose Jesus today. Let us sing, "I Have Decided to Follow Jesus."
I choose to.
Can we say amen to that?
Amen,
amen. I'm going to invite the director back up again. I realized I forgot to introduce myself. My name is Samuel Vargas. I'm the music ministry coordinator here at High Point. And you are?
Oh, I'm Cyril. I'm currently on my last semester of a master's in choral conducting from Andrews University.
That song we just sang, I Have Decided to Follow Jesus. It's very evident that you as a choir have decided to follow Jesus, and that has led you here. Can you tell us a bit about how about the process of coming here to the States to perform, and then how you ended up here in Tennessee?
I would love to, but you'll have to take a nap and...
can you get the synopsis, you know?
Let me try to make this as...
We'll put a word limit on it. How about that?
So when the kids decided to actually visit the U.S., the first step was to take a visa, of course, and from back home, it's very, very hard to get a U.S. visa. Any Filipinos here, Filipino community, you know how it is, the process. And so, they decided 2 months before our target date of departure, and so I told them, what we have to do is to look for visa appointments. And so when we checked the U.S. Embassy website, the first appointments that would come out is actually 4 months. There's 4 months of waiting time. So that is like late August or early September. So I said the first step is already dead end because they have to be back in the Philippines by August 2nd week. That's the start of their classes. And so I said, oh, it's impossible for you guys to go. And so we were trying to look for people who could help us. And they told us that you could request for an emergency appointment to the embassy as a group, and then they might, you know, who knows, they might allow you to have a group interview on a nearer date. So that's what we did. But to make the long story short, we got denied of that request. So the next step was, we knew that there are canceled appointments that would pop up midnight or early morning. I said, we have no choice. You guys have to be awake midnight, early morning, and try to look for the, you know, dates. And they have to do it individually. So I remember the first time that the first member got her visa schedule, we were so happy, as if she was already approved a visa, but that was just the schedule. And so we did that for the 2 months, actually. So on her first concert at Chicago, two members were not able to join, just because even in the last week, there were still some people who was trying to get their visas. But I remember my prayer before we all started this plan. And just for some of you who doesn't know me, I came to Andrews by faith. And my prayer, just a little backtrack, my prayer before I came to Andrews, I told God, Lord, if you want me to do something big, if you want me to do something big, you have to do something big for me. If you want me to study at Andrews, you have to provide everything for me. And the process of my studies was very, very hard. It was a step-by-step process. I got my visa, I was so happy, but that was a few seconds of happiness because I remembered I still didn't have a ticket yet going to the U.S. And I said, Lord, I remember my prayer. You have to provide everything for me. Someone provided my ticket on the plane. I was so happy. I said, yes, this is a dream come true. I'm going to study at Andrews in the U.S. And then I forgot I didn't have a place to stay. I didn't know anyone in Berrien Springs. When I got to California, someone introduced me to a friend who knows a friend that knows a friend that knows another friend at Michigan. And so I was introduced to that family. And when I got to Berrien Springs, they picked me up and they gave me a house to stay free for the past 3 years. Amen. They gave me a key. I thought it was a key to the house, but it was actually a car that I could use during my stay in Berrien Springs. But I only use it for one sem because I hit a deer after a semester. But God has provided everything for me. And when the plan of coming to the U.S. came into mind for these kids, I said, Lord, you have been so good to me. And I want other people to experience this too. I want the kids to experience this too. And I prayed for it. We prayed for it. And the mere fact that we are all standing here in front of you, it is all because of God's amazing grace.
Amen.
Coming to Tennessee was not part of the plan. We were supposed to have our last week of appointments in Chicago. For some reason, someone one of the leaders died in one of the churches, so they had to cancel our appointment there. We needed to stay there for a week, you know. And so there was a Filipino community in Florida who was willing to host us. Florida was not part of the plan too. And I said, oh, we have to go there. It's so hard to feed 18 people who eats a lot. And I said, let's go to Florida. But we have a gap week, because Florida is for next week. And I said, what can we do? So some of the members knew someone, and we are so thankful because Mom Esther, where's Mom Esther? Mom Esther right here, she has been hosting us this past few days. Mom Esther, thank you. When we got here, she just organized everything so well. This is probably one of our most comfortable week, you know, with everything. And then I happened to, of course, my good friend from Andrews, who happens to be from Southern, I told him, Robbie, we're here. And he said, why don't you sing tomorrow for It Is Written? And that's what we did. We sang there, we got another appointment, and we got another appointment. And that's the reason why we're everywhere. And it was not all planned. But I believe it's not a coincidence. It is God's, it's a divine intervention that we could be here, we could share our testimony. And we always believe that there's more to music. And it is the life we live and the testimonies that we can share with all of you. So I think that's it.
Amen, amen. We are so blessed to have you all here. And I really like that line that you said, when you said, when God calls you to do big things, He will do big things for you. I really appreciate that. Thank you for sharing, and we can't wait to hear the rest of what you have planned for us tonight.
Sin continues to corrode our world. Everywhere, evil shows just how much it has infected and decayed this once beautiful creation. Our minds are either brought to fear for tomorrow, or otherwise are ensnared by the enemy through distractions and pleasures in this world that keep our eyes, untune our hearts, and turn our minds away from fixing on Jesus. The world is dying, and time will soon run out. But don't lose hope. Jesus is coming, and if we remain faithful, we will rise with those who will sleep no more and meet Him in the air. Let us fix our minds on that coming time, and let us set our courses on the narrow way, holding fast from today until He comes.
For Look at your life and ask yourself, how does my journey fare? Where am I headed? In fact, why am I on a journey? What destination am I trying to reach? Think of yourself after a long, hard day at work. You're exhausted. You've endured so much, and yet your heart grows with excitement as little by little you make your way home. Life on earth is exhausting, and every day, sin tries to defeat us, tries to wear us out, and make us lose the race. But heaven waits. Jesus, with his arms open, and the prize of eternity waits for you at the finish line. Keep running. Keep going on life's journey with your eyes fixed upon Jesus. Our journey through, though coming close, is not yet over. Not until we reach our home. Let us all sing, "In a Little While We're Going Home."
Gonna take it all.
take it home to my Jesus in that good until I reach my bliss, until I reach my home, until I reach, my home.
How many of you have been blessed out there? Yes. I'm sure we can do better than that. How many of you have received a blessing from this choir? Yes. Amen, amen. Well, we're getting close to the end of the program, but before we wrap up for tonight, I just wanted to ask you, what is your mission as a choir? What keeps you going? Why did you start in the first place? And what's your reason and your why?
I grew up as a church choir boy. And back in the Philippines, there are so many churches who has not even experienced listening to a choir. And God, every time I wanted to do my own thing, just for you guys to know, when I was in college, I loved playing basketball, and I wanted to do that my whole life. But God, like what we sang a while ago, God will always hold me, and He would put me in the right place. So from playing sports into music, who would have thought? And He has always given me the inspiration to always share music in our church. I grew up in the church, and even when I was in college, He would always give me opportunities to teach the churches in the Philippines, not even the nearby churches. He gave me two churches to teach, to minister. It was 3 hours away from home. And I would remember riding on my motorcycle, rain or shine, going to the small churches, teaching church choirs, and I was so happy about it. I didn't receive much, but God has allowed me to experience such fulfillment in sharing music to these small churches. And I always pray that these young people will also develop this passion to reach out to churches, to share our music to churches. And that's the very reason why we're here in the U.S. I told God, if this is your will, then you will let this happen. And so far, we have been visiting a lot of churches in probably 4 different states now. And we just love doing this. And this is not only something that you know will allow them to tell their friends and their parents later on when they go back to the Philippines that they've been to America, but more importantly, they can tell the people, their friends, their families, that we've visited churches and that music has been very effective in the ministry that we have been sharing there. So this is what we love to do, and that's why we're here.
Amen, amen. And before we close, is there anything else you'd like to say to the church here?
Oh, thank you so much for welcoming us. I really didn't expect, I don't know when this was organized, but seeing all of you here just tells us and God reminding us that everywhere we go, He will always send people to, you know, inspire us. And I think this is a symbol of what we will be doing in heaven. You know, we will all be gathering together. We will be singing songs together, songs of praise. And we just hope that in every note, in every music that we've given to you this afternoon, only God's name was glorified.
Amen. Amen.
We are saved, sola gratia, by the grace of God alone. Our choir's very name reflects the core of our ministry, our service, our lives. We are here because of Him. We sing because of Him. We praise because of Him. And we serve because of His grace sufficient for each of us who are here this afternoon. As we will be ending this afternoon's worship with our last song, we hope that you all were blessed with the songs we could share. And let us always put in our thoughts about a great God that we worship. We will be reminded of these things as long as we look back at the cross, the priceless gift that gave us the ultimate grace, granting us salvation. For we are now living in Christ, and He lives within us.
When I look back on what I thought was living, I'm amazed at the price I chose to pay. And to think I ignored what really mattered, 'cause I thought the sacrifice would be too great. But when I finally reached the point of giving in, I found the cross was calling even then. And even though we took dying to survive,
I've never felt so much alive. Not I, but Christ lives within me. His cross will never ask for more than I can give. For it's not my strength, but His. There's no greater sacrifice. For I am crucified with
hands surrender to His piercing purpose that holds me to the cross, yet sets me free. I will glory in the power of the cross. The fees I fought for gain, I count as
Christ is within me. there's no greater sacrifice. For I am crucified with Christ, and yet I live. For I am crucified with Christ.
Was a real blessing. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. We are blessed by your ministry, and we pray that you will continue to share your talents with other churches, and God will continue to provide for your needs as you travel and share his wonderful love through music. Let's have a closing prayer. Pastor Lee, can you come pray for us?
Well, I really hope that we can have 2 more hours here. You like that, right? But that might be a challenge for them. They have been singing everywhere. And I'm so much blessed. Thank you very much. You know, so God, I use all your talents to bless more people. You know, music and travel. Music can stay, right? When you go home, it's not to go home. Wow, it's a piece of music. I think whatever they send this afternoon, you know, stay in your hearts, you know. So, well, I do have friends, you know, so I know that they have traveled that far away, you know, so... if God move your heart when you leave, we do have 2 small container outside over there. If you're willing to have like free will offering, you really wanted to help them to travel like to Florida or to return home, you know. So if God move you, you know, so please, you know, when you leave there, you know, so we put it on that table and both sides, and if you don't mind, this is their table, will be the one side over there, one side over that side. So thank you, thank you very much for being here with us. You know, so I really hope that Esther can brought them like earlier. It's not this week, it's probably 2 weeks ago, huh? Then we have more time to spend with them. Okay, let's pray. Lord, we thank you very much. What a joyful afternoon, Sabbath afternoon. Lord, I know when my brother and sister sing, and I can see the thought of the angel all join here. Lord, thank you. Thank you for this gift of a voice. Lord, and bless these young little people. They are willing to put aside their priorities and they prepare themselves and they use that to praise you, bless the people, Lord. You know, when I sit there and listen to your testimony, how you working it out all the way, and I know, Lord, you have been leading them, and I know you will continue to do so. Lord, wherever they go, please go with them. Lord, use this group of young people. Let them shine for you. Lord, let the voice be lifted up and let all the songs stay in our heart. Lord, we thank you. When we depart from here, let us not just leave. Let's not leave with your presence in our hearts, with your Holy Spirit. And Lord, we just pray for double portion of Holy Spirit for upon this group of young people. Lord, empower them when they go back to Philippines, when they go back to the school. Lord, that will help them remember, Lord, that you do have a calling for them. And not only in Philippines, but around the world, Lord, there's a field that you need them to go, to sing for you, to praise for you. Thank you, Lord. Bless each and everyone who are here. And may you fill our heart with this great joy when we go home and let the joy stay. Thank you so much, Lord, for being with us. Thank you. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, by the way, so I do like it. So our church leaders do like, well, if someone want to join there, I don't know if you guys want to do hiking or something. If you do, and so some young people want to join them, you can just talk to our Brian. Where's Brian? Brian Bissell. Oh, Brian's there. Okay, so he's going to organize a little bit. Like, if they wanted to go, they are going to have a little hiking and so after that. So, but please be seated. Thank you very much again. Thank you.